Well, you know, staying cool is not easy when it is nearly 100 degrees outside.
And on days like today, the thick air can make it difficult to breathe, especially for young children and adults working outside.
Our Bill O'Neill joins us now live with tonight's big story at 6 o'clock. Bill?
You know, guys, health officials predicted that this would be a code orange alert kind of a day, but our chief meteorologist, Lanny Pope, just told me that we haven't quite made it there. However, there is another code orange alert for tomorrow, and what this means is that there is a danger of too much ozone in the air. That's bad for everyone, but especially the very young and the very old. It's high noon, and young soccer players are entering their fourth hour of practice at JC Park in Greensboro.
It's hot because I sweat a lot and I have allergies to that, kind of.
What'd you do about all this heat?
Kind of stay in the shade.
Counselors running this summer camp for the Carolina Dynamo soccer program say shade and water breaks are how they deal with the heat.
Just relax and get in the shade as many times as possible, because kids at this age will overheat within minutes.
Kids in that age range, of course, most of them will get away with anything.
Dr. Clint Young says parents shouldn't be surprised if their kids, who spend a lot of time outdoors in this kind of weather, end up coughing or complaining about headaches or tightness in the chest later tonight. The code orange alert is for ozone, which is created by the sunlight hitting the exhaust from your car. It means dangerous weather conditions for the very young and the very old. But it can also present problems for anyone who spends a lot of time outdoors in this kind of weather, either working or exercising.
The trick, again, is to figure out how much of a problem it really is. Again, we can't vaccinate a person against the weather quality. The people who really have a problem end up having to change their lifestyle a little bit.
Dr. Young urges everyone to restrict outdoor activity to early morning or evening hours. But if you're planning outdoor activities in the heat of the day, tennis instructor Robbie Todd says you need to hydrate your body 2 to 3 days ahead of time.
The body needs a little bit more time to get adjusted to the conditions. And so often if somebody's dehydrated from the day before, drinking plenty of water on the day of your match isn't going to give you enough time.
He also recommends proper clothing, wearing material called dry fit instead of cotton.
Much better than cotton, really. Cotton's going to get very sweaty very fast. It's going to stick to your skin. It's going to be really uncomfortable to play in. So this is much better.
Wearing the right clothes, drinking plenty of water, and taking breaks in the shade will help. But they can't change the fact it's hot.
Now, how long are we out there playing?
I've been out there probably a total of 30 minutes.
How do you feel?
I feel exhausted, like I've been out there for 4 hours, you know?
Of course, the best way to beat the heat is to stay inside, either your home or your car, where there's air conditioning. I'm sorry that my photographer, Rich Sisney, is still out there sweating, but I promise, guys, he will get water and get the air conditioning of the TV truck as soon as we're done with his live shot. Back to you guys.
All right, someone get Rich some Gatorade. Thanks a lot, Bill. Here are some facts about Code Orange Days. There are two types of alerts, ozone and fine particles. Ozone code orange alert days are called when ozone pollution is predicted to reach unhealthy levels for sensitive groups. When this happens, active children and adults and people with lung disease like asthma should limit prolonged outdoor exertion. Fine particle code orange alert days are called when fine particle pollution is predicted to reach levels that are unhealthy for the sensitive population. When this occurs, people with heart or lung disease, older adults and children should avoid prolonged or heavy exertion outdoors.